name which was helpfully coined by Graham Atkin, which is much catchier than what it was, which was 24-hour play festival. This is going well so far. Okay, so I'm Natalie, I'm president of Cuts, and as you can tell by that little display, I'm really, really tired right now. I've been awake so thank you for so many of you turning up tonight, even though you had literally no idea what you were turning up for. It's great to see you all here. We embarked on this mammoth task of creating short plays within 24 hours. The writing team assembled here this time yesterday and worked through the night to produce the show that you're going to be seeing tonight. The stimulus was the song All Along The Watchtower, originally by Bob Dyllan, which you might have heard as you were coming in. Each group had a different version of the song, so it kind of influenced the way that they might have interpreted it and in their play that they eventually got from that. So from 7 a.m. this morning, the actors and the directors all turned up, rehearsed and learnt lines all day. It's really been pretty intense, really intense. So first of all, I need to warn you that there will be some strong language and some adult themes in some of the plays. There are 4 short plays. There's a 20-minute interval after the second play, and there'll be refreshments in the foyer. There's so many people to thank for this, but mostly I'd just like to thank every single person that's been here for the last 24 hours while we've been working. Without all of you, it just obviously wouldn't have happened. So thank you for your kind donations as well. Obviously, this is a charity event, and everything's going to Mind. So it's a charity that means a lot to a lot of us, so that's brilliant. There's no planned fire drills tonight, if there is a fire, but exits are here and here. And finally, I'll introduce our first play. It's written by Liz Milne. Where are you, Liz? There's a wave. It's called There's Got to Be a Way Out of Here. It was directed by Jamie Moores, and it stars Heather Matthews and Lucy Whitfield. So I hope you all enjoy the show.
What do you mean? 2 months. The company goes bankrupt.
That was not my fault. The GC gave you a dark patch, you know, there. The director should have noticed. Look, come on, I brought us here so we could check it out. If it was any good, I would have told you.
A bit, no, I know what this is. This is some psycho message that he's gonna come out and kill us somewhere. He's got women stored in the back.
Psycho serial killers. You fucking mad you are.
You don't really think there could be some psycho? Oh God, I've killed us.
Well, we've got to find a way out of it. Now.
Any further along, are we?
No.
But we feel better about it.
Should we at least try and find a way out?
Yeah,
trick! Someone's playing a joke on us! Who would do this to us? Why?
Oh. No. You know who this reminds me of? You know him.
No! Well, he said he'd swore revenge for what he did to us.
Oh, he did, didn't he?
He fucking deserved it after what he did to us.
Yeah.
He was pretty mad after what we did.
Yeah.
Well, you know what? We survived that. We survived this. Come on, we can do it together.
Yeah.
How did it happen?
I can't remember exactly. We was in acting school. And there's that big party. That's what it was.
Well, this party's good, isn't it?
It's not that bad.
Oh. Oh, he is hot. Oh, he is hot. I would. I really, really would.
You dirty man.
Oh, look, he's calling. Oh.
He's calling his boat over.
Well, come on then, we can't leave him waiting! Oh, yeah, it was that shit party with what's his name?
Yeah, and then what happened?
fucking shit, didn't it?
So easily.
Oh, by the way, congratulations on lighting out the outside area. So then everyone could watch him be naked.
And then he took over his own feet and you pushed him in the car pond.
Oh, he was proper mad, wasn't he?
He's not a lunatic, is he? You don't think he's gonna do something stupid? It does kind of seem like the guy to hold a grudge. Maybe try and get revenge?
Oh yeah, but what can he do? Like seriously, what can he do? You don't think it's him, do you?
No.
But it could be.
No.
It would make sense if it was him.
What a prick.
Yeah.
He's a fucking joker and a thief, that's what he is.
What?
He broke our hearts, didn't he?
I don't get what?
And he likes to play little games, little jokes.
Yeah, he plays jokes, but they're not funny. He always takes it too far.
Yeah, he does, and that's what makes him a joke and a thief, doesn't it?
I don't get what you're talking about.
But it's that song again. It goes something like, there must be some way out of here, like the joker to the thief. That
doesn't fucking matter.
No, it's alright, I get it. I don't like it, but I get it.
You do think it's him, don't you?
If it is him, then I don't want to stay here.
Yeah, come on.
What the hell are you doing?
I'm looking for a trap door.
Oh yeah? Because clearly I remember we climbed up in here through a rope ladder. Like stairs underneath the floor.
Oh, I know. One of those ropes you used to have in gym where they had a knot every 2 feet or so.
Don't be so sarcastic.
Those ropes really were awful, weren't they? Especially do you remember Mrs. Hopkins?
You know, with the awful teeth.
What did she used to say?
Remember, girls, a healthy boy is a requirement for young girls.
Fucking bitch. Doing?
normal way because we don't remember it, right?
Yeah.
Which means that a normal door exists on the other side of this wall, but it's just like disguised or something on this side, so we can't find it.
Yeah.
Now, we're not saying this is some magical room, are we?
No.
Not some James Bond villain hideout with secret technological thingamabobs around or like sliding floors.
No.
So that means if we're methodical about this, and if we check, we'll be able to hear where the door is.
Yeah.
All right, so come on, help me.
Okay.
By Ed Little, directed by Natalie Webster, and with actors Kerrianne, Maloney and Cobb.
Problem with oral is that chicks never tell you what to do with it.
The real problem is they don't want you to do anything with it.
I don't know. I don't have direction. I'm lost, and my tongue's moving. I'm sort of making these noises if I can sort of echolocate what the fuck I'm supposed to do.
That sounds like it could hurt.
It does. My tongue has the sort of coordinate ability of a crab. It moves from left to right, but it can't go up or down. And circles. Fucking impossible!
I'm glad you're being honest about your flaws. Can we move on? Harper brought one of his little bunnies again.
Forget about the girl. And as to my flaws, I've gotta be honest. I have fucking tons.
Like what?
You know, the way that I don't take serious things seriously.
Well, guy, I just need to leave.
You can't leave. What, go to back to Ohio and get a job as a journalist? Write fucking articles about cornfields? You should stay in Chicago and live with me. And, you know, throw eggs off Franklin Street Bridge.
Naming them beforehand.
Bye, Bill Dylan. Fuck you, Jimmy.
Do you really want to stay here forever?
What's wrong with here?
There's no spark to singing backup to some yuppie like Harper. We've been playing now for 2 years. Do you really want to do this for another one? I mean, hot sardines.
Weren't we deep banana blackout?
Yeah, but last month we were bad toilet backwash.
We should form our own band. Something fresh and original, like guys and gals.
How about the echolocation of oral pleasure?
I think we both know that wouldn't work. No direction.
Okay, but seriously, what should I do? I can't keep playing forever.
About Chicago? Or Harker? I mean, you do what you gotta do. You said it yourself, Harker's a fucking yuppie. I mean, last night he tried to get away with saying razzmatazz.
Fucking razzmatazz!
And his first name's Richard, which says a lot.
What about guys with other names? Not Richard.
You should find yourself a Matthew. Matthew's the kind of name would give you chili after church.
I'm not religious.
Neither am I. But, you know, if you want to go for drinks with guys like Matthew on a Friday night, you've got to make compromises.
Wait, if you feel like this, then why are you still here?
I told you, Gwen. I have no direction.
Oh,
God.
There's guys like me who work.
There's guys like me who work for businessmen. I just, you know, I work my hours, and then when things quieten down, I have my
job. Oh, Jesus. Don't you feel like you're losing potential experience? Like, I know I'm stuck in a rut, but at least I'm angry about it.
I don't know. I guess I'm content playing sax in the hot bananas.
Hot sardines.
Doesn't really matter. Either way, we're shit.
Well, at least we can drink.
See you in the morning.
More time to sober up?
To being shit. You really think that's a good idea?
When Guy gets back at 9, I'm gonna get my stuff from that back room, and I'm gonna quit. So yeah, I do.
Last night was a fucking disaster. I mean, the audience. Unresponsive bunch, you ask me. An absolute lack of taste. We're a smash, the hot sardines. We're fucking fantastic.
British guys don't usually use the word smash.
Sure they can. I mean, anyone can use lingo. They've just got to have the confidence. You know, the Rasmus has.
Razzmatazz? Yeah, you really got the lingo.
I brought that with me from England. Kids, my uncles. I mean, obviously, you live in it. He took me to Oxford once. Great place, Oxford. It's got a nickname. City of Dreaming Spiders. You love shit like that as a kid, don't you? Nicknames. But, you know, I was 12 for cartoons at that point, and Uncle Paul wouldn't want me watching them.
Looks like you really made it big then, huh? You know, Chicago's pretty big compared to Oxford. From the small pounds to the big bucks. Harper, you should be grateful.
Grateful? I don't know, I just... I feel like I'm missing something. Really?
Do you ever wonder if coming here was a mistake? Like, if everything we're doing is just wasting time?
So worked out so far. It's all fallen into place. It's convenient. It's practical. I mean, this happened. Us. I guess I'm grateful for that.
Wait, you guess?
Well, yeah. I mean, I love you, Gwen, but this is just practical. If you weren't in the picture, somebody else would be.
Practical. I didn't really have it down as practical. Like, I get it. Like, chance happens, but I didn't realize this was a matter of coincidence and practicality.
Well, you know, we're just together because we can't be alone.
Oh.
We've seen of each other.
Selfish.
You know what? It's selfish. It's selfish the way you love me. You want me to act and feel the way that you want me to?
I want you to act how you feel. There's no sort of emotional manipulation going on here.
I'm just being real.
Yeah, you're being real, of course, of course. What you're being is an ass. Oh, sorry, ass. I don't get it. You pretend that it's real to make up for your offense. It's just a lack of sensitivity.
You know, it's really cute when you act this way. You pretend to be this sort of strong icon for womanhood, but you're too romantic at the same time. You're your own contradiction. What's that diplomat?
The last line.
This isn't feminism.
Feminism, right, okay. See, I had that down as this crazy notion that women are people. So here I am, a woman, as a person.
Being a person doesn't make up for being misinformed.
Oh.
I need to ask you something. I think you should move in.
Fuck off. What, that I should move with you? That we should live together? What, so we can bring a happy family in a pretty fucking garden in the English countryside? Your little bunny's by here, by the way. In the back room. Yeah, Harper. So why don't you go have a jolly good time? Cheerio. Get on your merry fucking way!
Hey, look who's back! The sauce in the sardine can! The backwash in the toilet bowl!
Hey.
The Moorish mother of oral pleasure!
Alright, calm down, buddy, you're slurred. For a guy who's unemployed, you're awfully charismatic. Anyway, back to reality now.
You kidding? There's no one more real than me. Now that 007 has fucked off back to England, we can get back to what really counts.
Playing shitty music in shitty garages and eating peanut butter cups.
Exactly! Playing sax in shitty bands with shitty lead singers. And that bored and confused look that women get when I try something practical.
At least we're not throwing eggs.
I call that fucker little Harper.
Yes. Worton,
And our actors are Kristýna Wagner, Vicky Cobb, and Matt Short. So we hope you enjoy.
Cut that shit out!
Oh, sorry. I've never been solitary companion before. Fuck, I've only been here for 3 weeks.
I said cut that shit out. I didn't ask for your fucking life story.
Sorry, I was just trying to...
Stop fucking apologising! We're criminals! Manners are out the doors and we came in! See me then.
As long as it takes. You should seek salvation before it is too late.
I've already told you, I don't need salvation. I'm innocent.
Stand up.
Stand up!
I'm not afraid of you or your God.
You say you are innocent in the eyes of God, but yours are not the eyes of an innocent man.
Fuck off.
I have not come to call upon the righteous, but the sinners.
Sinners to repentance. Yes, and as I've told you for the past 3 weeks, I am an innocent party.
We both quite know this is not exactly true. You were found 300 yards away from the crime scene, half naked. Your clothes were found 100 miles yards away from the crime scene, half burned, covered in blood.
Please, sister, just go.
You should seek to repent before it is too late.
Fucking A-team when she visits. Accused of a crime I didn't commit and all that.
Well, what crime did they accuse you of?
What did they accuse me of? So, you believe I'm innocent.
I'll give you the benefit of the doubt for now.
A woman was killed in cold blood for a goddamn handbag. A fucking handbag.
Heavy.
And then... Then the fucker then threatened me and asked for my clothes because he was half naked to make things worse.
So, you gave me clothes?
What else would I do? I mean, he threatened to take my life. I asked if I could call my partner and see if she could come pick me up. They complied and then they stole my phone too. You may be. Before my partner arrived, cop showed up, half naked I was. They then cuffed me evidence they needed to convict me.
It's real heavy. So, you're genuinely innocent then?
Straight up. I have not done a single crime. I'm innocent in the eyes of the law. My wife, she died 8 years ago. Traffic accident, they told me. My kids, well, I wish I knew. Eddie would be 28 now. Maddie, she'd be 23. Don't even know if they're alive. How fucked up is that? How about you?
Never married. Dated a few times, but, well, you know, that never works out in the end.
I don't know, actually. Me and my wife, we were childhood sweethearts. And one partner for my entire life.
That's sweet.
Yeah. It was. What now?
Last time I gave you this, you didn't quite want it. Take it.
So, what did you do before you got stuck in here then?
I was an office clerk. It was a shitty job. I was doing night classes on the counter.
Is in my thoughts again. There's no prisoner I'm drawn to as much. Such a horrific story.
Oh, fuck you! I love numbers. They're so serene and calming. Numbers don't lie. What line of work were you in anyway?
Investment banking.
Fuck you twice over. A glorified accountant.
I can sense God deep inside his soul. He used to be a religious man. I used to ask myself, what is it about prison that makes a person turn away from God? I think I understand that.
Don't you mean exciting accountant? The numbers don't lie. You know, it's funny. In my world, you can make the numbers do whatever you want them to. Well, my old world, that is. You want to know something funny? You want to know how I ended up in prison?
Not really. I'm depressed enough as it is.
Well, let's talk about something fun. You like movies?
I can still sense God deep in his soul.
Yeah, alright. I mean, a while ago, kind of the last one I saw. But you know, it stuck with me. I replay it in my head when I'm alone and solitary.
Yeah, what film?
It was Blade Runner.
Classic.
It was alright.
Alright. It's amazing. Genuine proof that sometimes the film can be better than the book.
It was a book.
So much denial of the Lord. Such clear evidence that he's committed the crime.
Well, yeah. Androids dream of electric sheep?
Do you mean the bear shit in the woods?
No, it's the book title.
Oh, wow.
And yet... Well, the book and the film are completely different, which works in the film's favour. Hang on, how long have you been here?
About 20 years. On death row the entire time. And then being in solitary for the past 7.
What I envy you. Nothing's original these days. Seems like... any book out there that's got at least 6 fans has been made into its own saga. Even comic books have been dug up from their literary graves and made into wimpified blockbuster movies.
I used to collect comic books while I was in here. Luke Cage, Iron Fist, The Avengers, and a few others. But mainly the first three.
The Avengers have had six movies or some shit like that. Luke Cage is getting his own show.
Shame I'm dead in 2 days.
Not really. The Avengers movies are garbage.
Well, as delightful as this conversation about all the things I've missed. You can tell me about all the crappy movies you like, but I'm never going to see my family again. Even now, that's a hard pill to swallow. It's painful. It dawns on you how many years you've spent in here, how many years you've missed of this old earth.
Well, why spend your last days being miserable and lonely? We had a good conversation, don't we?
Sure. No. Read me my rights, stride me to the chair. I've had enough. I'm not even going to say I'm innocent anymore.
It pleases me muchly, and our Lord, that you are finally moving towards acceptance.
Do you know
the tales of seals from the Revelation?
Ah, that religious crap. Seems to have escaped my oh-so-pious mind, so, no, enlighten me.
Do you know the four horsemen? Famine, pestilence, death, and war. I believe two of these brothers have touched you in your life. War. Within the way of ending peace, putting people against one another, making them kill each other, of course, concerning a case. And death, the rider that is on its way to cut you off for your sins. The howls that are at your window are his whispers. Are you ready to repent? Are you ready to repent?
No.
What a lovely woman.
She only means well. How come you're in here anyway?
You've changed too.
Well, I'm going to be dead in a few days, so why die bored and lonely?
Fraud.
Fraud? Fucking fraud!
You can't change your attitude on death from one day to the next.
Of course you can. Humanity's been doing it for years. So how'd you end up in solitary?
Well, that's a different tale entirely.
Well,
when I was a kid, I had a really bad habit of stealing. You know, I used to steal anything I could get my hands on. Pencils, books, cutlery, cassettes, CDs, anything small to fit in my pockets. But then I started to develop a bit more creativity. Started to steal things that are worth a bit more, I suppose. CD players, mobile phones. I'd always get caught. And I'd either be chucked out of the house or get a good idea from my mother. But eventually it led to muggings, which led to corporate theft, which eventually led to me being here.
Yeah, that's no explanation for why you're in solitary.
I was getting to it. Well, one of my more creative schemes
shit. How did you do it? And why did you do it?
Haven't you been listening? I steal things. That's what I do.
Is that the only thing you've stolen since you've been here?
The only thing worth it?
Last little chance of salvation.
Something like that. Though I've stolen religious jewelry before, and it definitely hasn't saved me.
How'd you do it?
Well, I took inspiration from things that you see in TV and movies, you know. But she doesn't sleep here, so I couldn't take it off while she slept.
Oh yeah, that's a classic.
And she always wears it on her neck, so it's not the same as, you know, stealing a key out of the warden's back.
Naturally.
The only time she takes it off is when she goes to the chapel to pray, and she holds it in her hands. Well, I had chapel privileges back then, so I went in one day, started messing with the lights, tore a page out of the New Testament, slipped it through an open window.
Brilliant.
Well, she starts going mad, going really excited, shouting out her prayers. When she drops the rosary, I come running in, you know, claiming that I'd heard her screams and wondering if she was okay. We were pretty pally back then, you wouldn't believe. I pick up and pocket the rosary. It was like an act of God in itself. It felt so magnificent. I almost stood for a moment then, almost believed in the old fella. Now that is a religious experience. Anyway, as I was about to leave, she called me back, saw the rosary sticking out of her pocket. She clocked onto the whole scheme, gutted.
Well, thanks for the entertainment. I'm going back to sleep.
It is time, Crow. The Pale Rider approaches.
Save it.
Oh, and Crow, before you go, thanks for the clothes.
Hey, stop!
No, you stop! Give me those clothes, and give me that rosary bead while you're at it.
What? No, fuck off. Get away from me.
Give me those clothes right now. I've got a knife in my pocket and I'll cut holes in your lodge in the Grand Canyon.
Okay. Okay, please don't hurt me. I'm married.
Oh, nice talk. And that's a bit, and give me the clothes.
Okay. Can I at least get my partner first? Otherwise I'll be half naked. I want to be picked up.
Can you fuck? You call the police. This isn't my first mugging, you know.
I'm sorry. Look, I swear on my life, on my belief, that I've
won. Oh, shove that religious bull crap up your ass. Just make it quick.
Hey, it's me. Could you come pick me up? Yeah, I know. It's not far though. Please, just come get me. Thanks. I'm sorry. No, it's not too late for forgiveness.
Shut up, and just pull crap back up like that to yours. You, typical religious types. Married, eh? No ring? Leaving a hotel at 1 a.m. in the morning with no luggage? Some good fucking Christian you are.
I'm sorry.
Oh, stop apologising for everything. You haven't done anything wrong. Not to me, anyway. Pansy religious types, you're all the same. Well, here's take your religious deed for the day. He who hath two coats, lend one to he who hath none. Or, you know, however it goes. Cheers for this.
No, please wait.
past words?
I've done some things that I'm ashamed of. But that bastard did this to me. I'm innocent. I'm innocent and goes to...
He's gonna need everything he's got to outrun them, especially at his age. Yes, yeah, I'll wait till he wakes up and tell him then. We've got a day or so before they get here, at least.
Back at last. And look at how she sleeps. She seems free of worry when she's asleep. Like she doesn't remember any of it. Oh God, please tell me that they're nowhere near here. If she can sleep like that, then she can't have found any trace of them. Still, I need to wake her up and find out for sure. Still, if they were anywhere near here, then she would have woken me up and told me. Far too young to be mixed in with this. Why did I even think we could escape from that place ourselves? I'll have to wait for her to wake up. Shouldn't be too long now. Looks like summer's morning.
Escape, of course.
mean, not every night, but a lot of nights for sure. There's a kind of relief, actually, when waking up from such a dream. Because in those moments, it's like you're still thinking that the world is different somehow. Like, completely different to how I thought it was in every way. And it's like the dream was the reality, and you've woken up from reality, and that was the dream. So in those few seconds, it's, you know, before the images fade, it's like I was finally living.
Well, it must be brilliant to see you having escaped. To be free from all the restraints, however briefly.
Perhaps.
It must have been the only thing you could cling to.
Well, it was, but after a while, I realised something. The dreams, they were always the same. There was nothing changed from them at all. So I would always be looking down at myself from above, and I could see myself crying because I hated it. I hated all the confusion, and I would watch myself try to escape, and every time I'd succeed and find some relief at last.
But didn't that inspire you? Why not?
Well, because then I'd have to wake up and stop and tell myself that actually there's no hope for escape, is there? Every morning after I woke, I would look at the horizon and it would be there, as sturdy as it's ever been, casting a colossal shadow on everything that we did. Seeing all we did and hearing all we said, I mean, except the dreams. And just a reminder that dreams have to end.
But you managed it. You're here now.
Well, yes, but what if I pinch myself and I wake up screaming?
Do you trust me?
More than anyone.
Close your eyes. Open them.
Still here.
How did the look go last night?
I'm sorry, I don't know what to do.
They're close. Elizabeth, how long?
There are a few days away.
Well, far. Go. Hurry. Go.
He's gone? I kept running, just like he told me to, and he's turned back and left me here. Why would he though? After all he promised to. He rescued me and he taught me to believe in something other than the dismal world that I knew. And now I'm alone without him again. That's worse than what that life ever could have been. Why was I so stupid to think that we could sit and rest for a moment with them constantly on our tails all the time? Why didn't I just tell the truth, no matter how dreadful, the moment I woke? Why didn't I tell him as soon as I knew how close they were, so that we could do something? We could have had one more day. We could have one more day together and just ignore the fear that they might find us tomorrow. Now I've wasted him, and I'm starting to wonder whether he was even here in the first place. Was it just another dream amongst all the other failed ones? Certainly faded, just like a dream. If he was ever real to begin with, that is. Why did I ever think that we could escape? What is the point in having hope if there's no chance of that hope ever coming true?
Elizabeth!
Ryder!
You run, no matter how much you think they won't, no matter what you believe in. It's vanity. If I could just. But wouldn't that be giving up? I could end up back there. The looming tower. I thought of seeing that again.
So then, something about yourself that will surprise me?
Sorry, where were we? I must have zoned out from you.
I was just asking about yourself, something about yourself that might surprise me. Don't worry, I've got all day.
Can I ask you a question instead?
Of course.
Do you ever get that feeling?
What feeling?
The feeling where it's like you have to swim just to get back into your own mind to understand what's happening right there, right then. It's as if you've lived 1,000 lives in the last second.
I can't say I have, no.
Oh, well, maybe it's just me then. Maybe it's all just me. Where are we again?
We're at the Watchtower pub on the corner of Prince Street. Been here all night. You okay?
Yes, yeah, I'm fine, yeah. Must be all the wine getting to me.
Yeah.
All along. Been in the Watchtower all along.
Well, look, it's been lovely getting to know you tonight, but it's the hour's getting late, and I'll pay. Yeah, I got you something. I don't really know why I got it, to be honest. It just screamed out at me, and I thought that I'd give it to you.
It's empty. Why would it be emptier? No, but that's just it. It's empty. It's empty because it escaped. It had escaped the whole time.
Thank you.
thank you to all of these amazing people. I'm sure you all agree that they did an amazing job, especially to learn all of those lines. I'm still in awe that they've managed to do that. That's absolutely amazing. So I'll tell you about the total money we've raised so far. I say so far because there is still a donation tin on your way out. So far we've raised £135.07, and that's all.